Hello people, in this video we want to look at cocaine poisoning. Okay, cocaine poisoning, let us look at now. Are you ready? Okay guys, get ready. Let's bring the mic a little closer. Here, how's that? Okay, so cocaine is also called as coke, crack, pasta, bazooka, speedball, snuff, snow, white lady. Like, you're going to remember all these names. At least remember cocaine, coca, coca. So coke, crack. Okay. And coke I eat with pasta. So pasta, bazooka, speedball, snuff, snow, white lady. If you can remember, snow and white lady are white, white. Okay. Now it is a deliriant poison. So it'll cause some kind of CNS effects. So this is the cocaine plant. This is the Erythroxylum coca. See, erythro means red, let's say red. Erythroxylum coca. Xylem to do with the plant something, xylem, phloem, etc. So remember, erythroxylum coca. Coca is already in the name. Cocaine. So coca. So erythroxylum coca. So this is erythroxylum coca. Focus on it. Learn the photo, because why you need photo? If you learn everything and you don't know how it looks, now total waste. I know you won't draw it in the exam, but at least. And then, this is an alkaloid, right? So now what are the physical properties of this thing? Let us look at this. Physical properties, guys. Now, physical properties of cocaine we have to look at. First, look at the introduction. It is an alkaloid deliriant poison obtained from the dried leaves of this Erythroxylum coca. And it is a shrub which is indigenous to Peru, Bolivia, Mexico, West Indies and Indonesia. So you're going to find it in these countries. That's a shrub. Then physical properties. Now physical properties, it is colorless, odorless, crystalline substance with bitter taste and slightly soluble in water and freely soluble in alcohol. Did you understand? It is colorless, odorless, crystalline substance, like sugar you can say, but it is bitter in taste and slightly soluble in water but freely soluble in alcohol. Okay, let's get a photo if we can from the internet. So here's cocaine, white. It's showing white here, but actually they have written here colorless, odorless, crystalline substance with bitter taste. Wow, it's bitter taste. Then I don't know why they are using it. Okay, that was the physical property. It is readily soluble in water, readily soluble in alcohol, and slightly soluble in water. Moving on to the mechanism of action, cocaine has sympathomimetic properties. So euphoric effect will be brought about by increasing synaptic concentration of the monoamine neurotransmitters like dopamine, norepinephrine, serotonin. So it makes the person very, very happy because you're increasing what and all these monoamine neurotransmitters like dopamine, norepinephrine and serotonin. So it is going to create a euphoric effect. It has all the sympathomimetic properties, right? Cocaine, what and all are the other mechanism of action. It has local anesthetic action. So it has local anesthesia action. It blocks initiation and conduction of nerve impulses by decreasing the axonal membrane permeability to sodium ions. So it is going to act as a local anesthetic also. Then what else? It is stimulating the cortex for a short time followed by depression. Similar effect. Always they stimulate and then they depress. What are the routes of administration that people take? Let's see, route of administration. They chew it, they apply it to the nasal mucosal membrane. This is snorting. You know, they put it in this paper, all this powder, and they snort it. They smoke it. That's called as free basing. And also they take IV. IV route of drug administration. They eat it, nasal, mucosa, smoke, everything. Whatever possible on earth they are doing. Then moving on to the fatal dose. Guys, we are moving on to the fatal dose. Remember, route of administration is over. We are moving to the fatal dose of cocaine poisoning. 1 gram orally, 20 milligram IV. If you just take an IV with 20 milligram, gone, you're dead. What is the fatal period? Just few minutes to few hours, the person is dead. If you just put 10 milligram, 20 milligram IV, fatal period, within few minutes to few hours, that person is dead. Okay. Signs and symptoms. So let us see the signs and symptoms of cocaine poisoning. Where are we actually, guys? We are looking at cocaine poisoning, correct? So we are moving on to the signs and symptoms of cocaine poisoning. How many people are awake? How many people are sleeping? Let us just take a check. Guys, what are we studying? Cocaine poisoning, correct? So what are we looking at? What did we just finish? Route of administration. What are we going to? Signs and symptoms. Fatal period. Fatal dose also over. Okay. Signs and symptoms, onset is within 7 seconds after inhalation. So within 7 seconds after inhalation, inhalation is much faster, they are saying. IV is after 15 seconds actually. And some things after oral ingestion, after 10 minutes, you will see some stages. The first stage is the stage of excitement. So the person is feeling in the local, wherever locally, he's feeling numbness, tingling at the place of application. Then the face is flushed, the skin is pale. Alright, we need a man for this. Please bring a man. So here's our man. We're explaining the stages of excitement, right? So we need to draw in a different one, or we can draw here only. Okay, just see here. So locally he will feel numbness, tingling, face is flushed, skin is pale guys. Then GIT, he has bitter taste, dryness of mouth, vomiting, diarrhea, hyperactive bowel sounds. Hyperactive bowel sounds will be grr, 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 grr. And bitter taste is going to be there. Dryness of mouth, vomiting, diarrhea. So this is indicating vomiting and this is indicating diarrhea. Okay. And hyperactive bowel sounds. Obviously diarrhea, hyperactive bowel sounds will be there. Coming to the central nervous system, he's basically, this is a state of excitement, remember. So definitely he's going to have a sense of well-being, euphoria. Right? Initially, he will be euphoric, restlessness, excitement, talkative, delirium, maniacal, hallucinations, tremors, tonic-clonic seizures, exaggerated reflexes. Right? Lot of excitement here. Then respiratory system, obviously, he's going to have tachypnea. Right? But with dyspnea, cyanosis. Cyanosis means blue color. Right? Then CVS, what happens to the heart? The heart also increases its heart rate, tachycardia, hypertension, ventricular arrhythmias can be there. The temperature, what happens to his temperature? His body temperature goes up, there's hyperthermia. Ocular, the pupils are dilated, resulting in blurred vision, okay? So basically everything is going up. The brain is overstimulated, convulsions can be there, hallucinations, deliriums can be there, seizures can be there, reflexes will be exaggerated, he's talkative, he's excited, he's euphoric, he has a sense of well-being. Now coming to the heart, tachycardia, hypertension, arrhythmia, coming to the respiratory system, tachypnea, dyspnea, cyanosis, face is flushed, the skin is pale, there is locally, whatever he has done, there's numbness, tingling in the GIT, there is bitter taste, dryness of mouth, vomiting, diarrhea is there, then hyperactive bowel sounds will be there. Now temperature, his body temperature has gone high, ocular, he can see his pupils are dilated and there is blurred vision. So these are this is the stage of excitement in cocaine poisoning. Take a deep breath. Now we will go to stage of depression. Now bring the same man and let's make him depressed. Now in stage of depression, what happens? So we are going to cover stage of depression now. In stage of depression, CNS, what will happen? There will be coma, there is areflexia, pupils are fixed, pupils are still dilated, they are fixed. Flaccid paralysis, loss of vital support organs. Coming to cardiac, that is CVS. There is ventricular dysrhythmias resulting in weak, rapid, irregular pulse and hypotension, circulatory failure and cardiac arrest. Cardiac arrest. Go on, kiss. Then, respiratory system, what happens? Respiratory system, there is Chyne-Stokes respiration, okay? Chyne-Stokes respiration, apnea, pulmonary edema, cyanosis and respiratory failure. Now, respiratory failure. Go on, kiss. Then, kidney. What happens to the kidney? The tea-colored urine may indicate, there's tea-colored urine, rhabdomyolysis and potential renal failure, gone. Kidney also failed. So basically in the stage of depression, after 1 hour, what happens? This guy initially was totally excited, now he's totally depressed. After an hour, the respiration becomes slow, there is profuse sweating, the patient becomes calm and dull. So his CNS is going into depression, coma. And his pupils are still dilated, they are fixed. There is flaccid paralysis, loss of vital support functions. The cardiac, what is happening? Ventricular dysrhythmias. There is going to be weak, rapid, irregular pulse, hypotension. So everything is going down. Circulatory failure, cardiac arrest. Respiratory, there is going to be Chyne stroke respiration, apnea, pulmonary edema, cyanosis and respiratory failure. Kidney, tea-colored urine And this will indicate rhabdomyolysis and potential renal failure can happen. So all the best to people who are taking this cocaine. Very happy you should be taking excitement and depression. Wow. Then coming to treatment, now comes the doctor's job. How will you treat this man? Okay, treatment is here, guys. Please pay attention here. Now we are going on to treatment. How will you treat this guy? Poor guy, he has come to you. So intensive support therapy you will have to give in case of acute intoxication. Okay, so now comes our job. Treatment. Now treatment is intensive support therapy, supportive therapy in case of acute intoxication. So decontamination, first you will do decontamination. If injected, apply tonic above the part so that the blood will not flow back, right? So you'll apply a tonic, that is a tourniquet, that is a band you will apply, like a blood pressure cuff, so that if he has taken injection, the proximally you will apply this tourniquet so that the blood supply is not going to the heart, it's not going to return to the heart. If applied to nose or throat, wash out with warm water or saline. Now this guy, what he did, he has taken this cocaine into nose or throat. If he has taken this cocaine into nose or throat, if he has taken it into nose or throat, then what you should do, you should wash this nose and throat with warm water and saline. If he has swallowed it, what will you do? You will do gastric lavage, you will give emetic, right? So that he will, you can remove the contents. You can also give potassium activated charcoal as a universal antidote. Now coming to supportive treatment. Yes, I understand the neighbor's dog is barking. Can't help it. What to do? Okay, so let us go to supportive treatment. Now supportive treatment, you can give diazepam to control the seizures. You can give cardiac life support like ALCS protocols to treat dysrhythmias. Ventricular arrhythmia you can manage with propranolol, esmolol. So these are all beta blockers, correct? So you can use these beta blockers for tachycardia and hypertension. You can give thiamine and you can give artificial respiration and oxygen inhalation. So did you understand the treatment? Did you understand the treatment, guys? The treatment, specific treatment, is diazepam to control the seizures, cardiac life support. You can give propranolol, esmolol, thiamine and artificial respiration, oxygen. What does thiamine do? Thiamine actually is vitamin B1, right? So it is used to treat vitamin B1 deficiency. Why are they giving it here? It's just not very sure of that. Okay, so let's move on now. Treatment is over, guys. Treatment, you will give symptomatic and specific. You will give diazepam, esmolol, propranolol, thiamine, okay, cardiac life support, etc. Now coming to postmortem findings, okay? Let's move on to postmortem findings. If this person dies, then what will you find in his postmortem? Postmortem finding, you can see linear excoriate legal importance. Linear excoriate, this is of legal importance. What is this linear excoriate? Let's find out. Basically, these are scratch marks, that's all. Linear excoriate. Then it is postmortem findings, accidental death. Why are they combining medico-legal importance? They're combining medico-legal importance here. So let us again say medico-legal importance here. So this cocaine can be used as a substance abuse, correct? It is a poison, rarely homicidal, suicidal. There can be accidental deaths can happen. Then overdose can be seen in body packers, body stuffers. It can be used as an aphrodisiac to increase sexual drive and duration of sexual act, okay? That's all, guys. So medico-legal importance also we have covered. So this is about cocaine poisoning, but this is not over yet. Still, we have some more under this cocaine. So basically, there is something called as cocainism. What is cocainism? Also, you should know. Wait. Cocainism is nothing but a chronic cocaine habit, okay? A chronic cocaine habit. So this comes under abuse, right? Substance abuse. It's a chronic cocaine habit. It is called as cocainomania or cocainophagia. So it can be called as cocainomania or cocainophagia. So this guy is going to be addicted to this. It is a chronic habit. It's a substance abuse, you can say. An abuser can tolerate up to 10 gram per day. Imagine, we saw the fatal dose of cocaine, right? What was the fatal dose? We saw that the fatal dose was 20 milligram IV. And they can tolerate 10 gram per day. Interesting. Grams they can tolerate. What are the signs and symptoms of cocainism? There will be emaciation, anorexia, digestive disturbances, significant loss of libido. Interesting, they're using it as an aphrodisiac and they're having significant loss of libido. So this happens in chronic use, okay? There can be impotence, gynecomastia, galactorrhoea, and major derangements in menstrual cycle in women. I mean, or here, infertility. So can you imagine what and all is happening? Galactorrhea, they are producing milk. They are having amenorrhea, infertility. Men are going to have loss of libido, impotence, gynecomastia. They don't feel like eating. They have digestive disturbances. What is emaciation? They have become very thin, right? Then the face is pale. Guys, wake up. If you are not awake, then you have to wake up. We every time give you a wake-up call. See, we are looking at what? Cocaineism. In that, we are looking at signs and symptoms. Now, we are moving on to that guy's face. Bring that guy here. Better. We'll scribble on this guy. You will be awake. So, now this guy, what and all signs and symptoms you saw? He has become very thin. Then, here, gynecomastia, loss of libido, impotence. In women, they could be like galactorrhoea, amenorrhea, infertility. All these terms, you know the meaning, right? Then, face is pale. This guy's face is pale. He is having shifty gaze, sunken eyes, dilated pupils. He's having, again, dilated pupils. We have already mentioned that. Blackish discoloration of the tongue and the teeth and ulceration of nasal septum. Perforation. Because these people are taking into the nose so much that nasal septum itself got ulcerated, I think. And if they are taking, I don't know how the teeth have become black, the tongue has become black. Oh, okay. The degeneration of the central nervous system. So central nervous system also is getting degenerated with hallucinations, convulsions, delirium. He is maniac, he is paranoid, and he has depressive psychosis. So everything, mania is there, depressive psychosis is there, right? Then this is also called as cocaine psychosis or excited delirium. Cocaine psychosis you can call it as, okay? Now there is some word here that you have to know that is called as Magnum's symptoms or cocaine bugs. So let us look at that here. There are some things you should know here other than whatever we said. You should know some things like Magnum symptom or cocaine bugs. These they will ask in the exam. Magnum symptom or cocaine bugs is characteristic in which type of tactile hallucination. This person has tactile hallucination. That means some kind of a touch, right? Tactile hallucination where the person feels as if grains of sand are lying under his skin and small insects are creeping on his skin, giving rise to itchy sensation. So he's telling under his skin there is sand and on his skin there is insects. There are insects which are crawling. So this gives to itching to him. So there is formication. I think that is why these people have this linear what did we call it as? Linear. Hold on, I need to go to that page. Linear excoriate. Okay, linear excoriate. Okay, so these people have all this because of this irritating skin that they think that there is grains of sand under the skin or there are insects crawling on him. So this is called as Magnan's symptom. Magnan's symptom or cocaine bugs. Magnan's symptom. Or cocaine bug. They will ask this in the exam. What are we talking about? Cocaineism. In which we are talking about cocaine bugs. Bugs on his skin. Right? Cocaine bugs. Magnan's symptom. Okay? Now, moving on to the medico-legal importance of cocaineism. Cocaine is a drug of addiction and many abusers develop cocaineism and may involve in crimes to fulfill their cravings for cocaine. That's all. So, we are done with cocaineism. Everything about cocaine is done. So, what else you want to know? It is called as PASTA. So, this is what linear excoriate and Magnan symptom, cocaine bugs. So, fatal dose is like 20 milligram into IV. Fatal period is few minutes, few seconds. Did they say few seconds? Few minutes to few hours. Okay. That's all. It's coming from this plant, Erythroxylum coca. It's a deliriant poison. That's all for now, guys. Enjoy. I hope you enjoyed this video. Take rest and come back for the next video. Bye-bye.